read a few verses from John chapter 16, John chapter 16 and verse 27. The Lord Jesus Christ speaking, he says, "For the Father himself loveth you, because ye have loved me." He's talking to his disciples here, "and have believed that I came out from God. I came forth from the Father and am come into the world. Again I leave the world and go to the Father." His disciples said unto him, "Lo, now speakest thou plainly, and speakest no proverb. Now we are sure that thou knowest all things, and needest not that any man should ask thee. By this we believe that thou camest forth from God." As I said earlier, the Father sent the Son to be the Saviour of the world. And that includes you and it includes me. You see, the salvation of God is sent unto us. You see, the Jews as a nation basically rejected the Son of God. They hung him upon a tree. He was crucified on that cross for your sin and for mine. But now the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ is going out to the whole world. Now it's going out to the Gentiles. And so not only is salvation available for the Jews, but it's also available for us as Gentiles. We're either Jews or Gentiles, and God wants you to be in heaven. God wants to save your soul. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." That everlasting life can be yours this afternoon through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't miss out on God's salvation. He's not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Repentance is a change of mind. It's coming to God and agreeing with him that, yes, I realize that I'm a sinner. And then we've got to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. That is God's promise to all who will call upon the name of the Lord. "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." That can be yours this afternoon. You can come back in the right relationship with your God. You see, there's only one true and living God, and we see the Lord Jesus Christ absolutely displayed him fully. When he was here upon the earth, he said, "He that has seen me has seen the Father." He's the exact representation of the Father. He's not the Father, but the Father sent the Son to be the Saviour of the world. And then the Son sent the Holy Spirit to bring conviction upon you and I, that we might understand that we're sinners in the sight of God and we need his salvation so badly. You know, it's such an urgent matter, this matter of salvation and redemption through the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ.